Welcome to Educate.com. This video talks about Newland's Law of Octaves. The objective of this video is to understand John Newland's attempt to classify elements, Newland's Law of Octaves, and drawbacks of Newland's Law of Octaves. The attempts of Dobereiner encouraged other chemists to correlate the properties of elements with their atomic masses. In 1866, John Newlands, an English scientist, arranged the then-known elements in the order of increasing atomic masses. He started with the element having the lowest atomic mass, that is hydrogen, and ended at thorium, which was the 56th element. He found that every 8th element had properties similar to that of the first. He compared this to the octaves found in music. Therefore, he called it the Law of Octaves. Hence, it is known as Newland's Law of Octaves. In Newland's octaves, the properties of lithium and sodium were found to be the same. Sodium is the 8th element after lithium. Similarly, beryllium and magnesium resemble each other. It was found that the Law of Octaves was applicable only up to calcium, as after calcium, every 8th element did not possess properties similar to that of the first. It was assumed by Newlands that only 56 elements existed in nature and no more elements would be discovered in the future. But later on, several new elements were discovered whose properties did not fit into the Law of Octaves. In order to fit elements into his table, Newlands adjusted two elements in the same slot, but also put some unlike elements under the same note. For example, cobalt and nickel are in the same slot, and these are placed in the same column as fluorine, chlorine and bromine, which have very different properties than these elements. Iron, which resembles cobalt and nickel in properties, has been placed far away from these elements. Thus, Newland's Law of Octaves worked well with lighter elements only. Even after the rejection of Newland's Law of Octaves, many scientists continued to search for a pattern that correlated the properties of elements with their atomic masses. In this video, you have learned. In 1866, John Newlands, an English scientist, arranged the then-known elements in the order of increasing atomic masses. He found that every 8th element had properties similar to that of first. He compared this to octaves found in music. Therefore, he called it the Law of Octaves. Hence, it is known as Newland's Law of Octaves. Drawbacks of Law of Octaves. It was found that Law of Octaves was applicable only up to calcium, as after calcium, every 8th element did not possess properties similar to that of first. It was assumed by Newlands that only 56 elements existed in nature, and no more elements would be discovered in future. Newlands not only adjusted two elements in the same slot, but also put some unlike elements under the same note. Thank you.
In many ways, the periodic table, like a map, can help us organize our knowledge of a diverse world, the diverse world of chemistry. How does a map organize information about an area? One way is to classify differences in the regions. For instance, A map might show by its colors and symbols that land is here and water is here, and a marshy area separates the two. This is a very broad organization of information. Information about the elements in the periodic table is broadly organized in a similar way, dividing the elements by their properties into regions of metals and metalloids and nonmetals. A map can also organize information according to similarities within a given area. A contour map, for instance, can organize information about a land area on the basis of elevation, or about a water area on the basis of depth. The periodic table also organizes detailed information. The elements are arranged in order of atomic number, the number of protons in a nucleus. Each row across, or period, shows one kind of relationship. Each column down, or group, shows another. The detailed relationships that the periodic table shows have made it probably the most important organizing instrument of chemistry.